Today we're looking at arpeggios. Hey guys, welcome to Thomann's Guitars and Basses. I'm here at the Luit Studio in Vienna and we're using one of the microphones for our bass amp. Today we're talking about arpeggios. You're instantly asking yourself, why the hell should I learn arpeggios? And I will tell you, because without arpeggios, you could not play this. Or this. I love the colorful clothes you wear. Or you also can't play the Donauwalzer, which would be a total disaster. So first of all, what are arpeggios? Arpeggios are chord tones played one after another. That means when you're playing a chord, you hear all those notes together, which gives you a specific sound or a specific feeling. When you play arpeggios, you're outlining the chord, also called broken chord or harp-like. This is so important in music because it is one of the main ingredients beside rhythm and sound. It helped me to improvise, to create new fill-ins and to navigate the fretboard. So we are going to look at major root arpeggios first. I'm going to show you the fingering of the D major arpeggio. The cool thing about it is, when you can play the D major arpeggio, you can also play the A major arpeggio, or the C, or D, or E major arpeggio, because it is always the same fingering. So, let's have a look. This is your open D string. And on the 12th fret, there is the octave. And then, go one octave down. This is the D. We want to play the arpeggio. So, this is my first, my second, third, and my fourth finger. I will start with the second finger on the D. So that's our first note. And then we need the major third, that's the F sharp. And I will play this with my first finger. And the fifth is the A. So I'm going to play this with my pinky finger. So it sounds like this. D, F sharp, A, F sharp, D. So this is our major arpeggio. So you can also add the octave. The D. And when you want to play it more legato, you can also try it with 3-4. Or. I would recommend you to turn on your metronome and just have fun with those three notes. You can also add the octave, but create some lines and have fun with it. And because you've got a D over here on the E string and a D on the D string, you can also add the D major arpeggio up here. So you would have. And if you want to play it legato, you can play 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1. And back with 2, 3. Now you can play the major arpeggio in every key. So let's go on to the minor arpeggio. You have to put your first finger on the D. Then we need the fourth or the pinky finger, fourth finger, on the minor third. So there you have got for every finger one fret. And now we just need the fifth, and that's the A with the third finger. So you've got D, F, and A. And then with the octave. And to play it more legato, you can play it like with your second and your third finger. The same like the major arpeggio, you can also play the minor arpeggio one octave higher. And that would be much easier for beginners. So you will have first finger on the D, and then the pinky finger on the F, and then the A with the third. That's much easier to handle. But it's the same fingering. Now we can also play the minor arpeggio in every key. And again, turn on your metronome and have fun with it. And now with the octave up. Especially in the Motown era, you can find a lot of bass lines using arpeggios. For example, How Sweet It Is to Be Loved by You by Junior Walker. James Jamerson is on bass. I'm going to read this because I didn't learn it by heart. To play a major and minor arpeggio in the root position. That means starting with the root note of the chord. But it's also possible to start with the third or the fifth, so you get the first and the second inversion. But the root position is enough for today, so have fun with it and make it your own. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave a comment. I'm really happy to answer them. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you, Luit, for letting us record in the studio. And I hope to see you very soon. Bye, everyone.